in the next few minutes. So if you are in the path of this storm, take it seriously. Stay away from windows. Get into the basement. Get into an interior room. Lowest level of your building. If you're in a taller building, you want to get down to the lowest level, away from the exterior walls, inside the interior of the building, and let the storm system pass on by. That cell there near West Friendship is an intense cell, and that is why the National Weather Service has issued the warning for a possible tornado in that area until 5 p.m. this evening. Right now, the rotation is continuing to push off to the south and east. It just does not look quite as distinct and as clear as the one that was in Carroll County a few minutes ago, but it's still a dangerous storm, no doubt about it, and it still may well have a tornado associated with it. So we are monitoring it very closely. Stronger winds indicated by Dover's radar on this one, which is, again, is hitting the storm a little higher up where the winds may be a little stronger. And this is the radar showing us wind velocity from the Sterling, Virginia one down near Dulles Airport, which gives us an indication that, again, it's in the general vicinity of West Friendship moving to the southeast. So I don't know if we have any camera. Yeah, here's a camera. What is that? That's 70 at 32, 70 at Maryland 32. So that's pretty close to where we would have possibility of this tornado here. And this is looking east. So 70 and 32 looking east. This system should be moving through that area very close to where this camera is here in the next few minutes. Although our radar now is beginning to lose some of that distinct rotation. Maybe it's shifting a little farther south of Interstate 70, but it's in that general area where you see the cars moving slowly there on Interstate 70 near Route 32. I would think this possible tornado is quickly getting east of there, but this is looking east, so that's a potential there for a very close call there where that picture was being taken there. So here's the warning area, the watches and warnings covering almost all of our region, the main threat area now in Howard County that goes from West Friendship along Interstate 70 over toward Ellicott City, and perhaps even into Catonsville if it holds together on that track into western Baltimore County. No indication it's going to do that. In fact, some indication that perhaps this storm is going to show some signs of weakening here. A good indication for us there, but the warning continues, and there you see the wind velocity, and again, not as distinct as the Carroll County one, but definitely some rotation indicated here, and definitely a storm that you want to take seriously. The radar tries to estimate the track of these systems over the course of the next several minutes, and so here's the general path and some of the neighborhoods that are in the path of this storm, including Ellicott City, Catonsville, and maybe Arbutus as well. So dangerous storm, tornado warning in effect for Howard County, for that cell that we see on our radar right there, sitting near Interstate 70 or just south of Interstate 70 in Howard County, moving past West Friendship, moving over toward Ellicott City and Columbia in the next couple of minutes. Dangerous storm system that is going to be there for a few minutes, and if it holds together, could get over toward Catonsville in Baltimore County as well. Notice that it was tracking right along Interstate 70 there, that little couplet right around Interstate 70 and tracking southeast. The storm track, the radar is estimating that this storm is moving at about 24 miles an hour. So it's going to whip through pretty quickly the way storms go. So it's sitting there. Let's see, let's zoom in a little closer and see exactly where that could be there. Just to the east of West Friendship, that puts the storm about 10 miles or so from Catonsville, so half hour is all it's going to take for it to get over to that Catonsville area, and it should be in the Columbia area there in 10-15 minutes. The radar sweeps around every couple of minutes, so these timings are going to be off by a minute or two here or there, but you definitely can see how fast it's going to be moving from West Friendship into Ellicott City, Columbia in 5-10 minutes, over toward Catonsville in 15 minutes or so, say a half hour, 15 minutes. So take shelter now if you're in the path of this storm, especially areas east of West Friendship, over toward, to say, Pine Orchard, Columbia, Ellicott City, and anybody along or just south of Interstate 70 there in Howard County should be taking shelter. Taylor, what have you got for us over there at the wall?
All right, well, they are still continuing the tornado warning. It's up for another 10 minutes or so, due to expire around 5 o'clock this evening, so we'll keep a close eye on that warning. For right now, there's widespread activity happening, and as Tom just mentioned, it's happening and moving through extremely fast. So if you are in the path of any of these storms that are intense, you need to seek shelter now, because you really don't have much much time to prepare. Again, the one we are zeroing in on right now is the Howard County one. It's moving east, south, and east at around 25 miles per hour, extremely fast. And notice right now, as Tom was mentioning as well, here's the latest breakdown of where these storms could be at exactly what time. So this tornado warned storm at around 5:11 near Cadenceville, and that's right on point what Tom just said. Takes him about a half hour to get there. Ellicott City, the top of the hour, Glen Burnie possibly at 5:35, and east of the city by 5:45. So again, moving very, very fast. And here's a better defined look at what is happening on radar velocity. Doesn't look as defined as it did about 15 minutes ago. So that kind of shows that we have seen some kind of weakening with this same storm. Nonetheless, we're still under that tornado warning for at least the next 9 minutes or so. Again, tornado watch continues through 9 o'clock this evening, and severe thunderstorm watch is ongoing through 9 o'clock as well for areas south and west highlighted in pink. Again, tornado safety, you need to take this seriously. Even if you're not under a tornado warning right now, you could be over the next couple of hours. So a breakdown of what to expect: get to a sturdy building, lowest level of your house, and of course away from windows as well. We'll keep you updated. For now, we're going to send it back over to Tom.
All right, thanks, Taylor. Just monitoring the National Weather Service chat, and they are continuing this at least for now. We'll see if they drop it early, but there is still some strong rotation being indicated there in Howard County, just south of Interstate 70. The storm track is picking up on the definite rotation there. There's Interstate 70 to the north of the possible rotation up here, and down here is where we could have the potential for some rotation. That would be just to the southwest of Pine Orchard. System is moving in the direction of Ellicott City and Columbia, and there definitely could be some strong rotation and damaging winds associated with this storm in this area of Howard County. A warning for possible tornado goes until 5 p.m. tonight. It is going to quickly make its way over to Route 29 and perhaps even hold together into Catonsville, although the National Weather Service has issued a severe thunderstorm warning for Baltimore and Anne Arundel counties, indicating the possibility of damaging winds from just straight line winds, not necessarily tornadic winds for those locations. But this is the area of concern here, getting close to the Ellicott City, Columbia area in Howard County. Zoom in a little bit tighter there and see what we can see. So there is the location of some of these neighborhoods in the path of this storm: Ellicott City, Columbia, Oakland Mills, Pine Orchard. This area right in here is where we would have the potential for rotation and possible tornado. So it's south of Interstate 70, and it's looking like it's north of Route 108. So this is the prime location here. If there's a tornado on the ground, it would probably be in this location here, coming closer to Columbia than Ellicott City, a little south of Ellicott City, down toward Columbia in this area of Howard County between Route 40 and Route 108. So take shelter now. We'll see if the Weather Service maintains this warning over the course of the next few minutes as this storm is moving through. But even if you don't get it, it is a dangerous tornado. It is a dangerous storm. There'll be some very heavy rain, intense lightning for a period of time, some strong winds as it makes its way through. Look at all those lightning strikes that we've picked up on here in just the past few minutes or so across that area. Numerous lightning strikes, 18 of them just the past couple of minutes coming down. So a dangerous storm, no doubt about that. And the storm is going to make its way into Catonsville and western Baltimore County, perhaps even make it into the city. A very strong thunderstorm there. Another one down in Montgomery County near Rockville. And all of these storms are tracking east-southeast 20 to 25 miles an hour. So be on the lookout there in Montgomery and northern PG County as well, perhaps over into Anne Arundel County. The tornado warning, the only one that the Weather Service has indicated has a strong possibility of a tornado, is the one in Howard County, where the warning goes until 5 p.m. And again, as we've been mentioning, it looks to us like the prime threat here would be south of 140, south of Interstate Route 40 and north of 108 in this area here, just to the northwest of Columbia. So please take it seriously. Get into the basement, wait for the sound of the storm to pass by. It looks like it's going to move through that area there south in Howard County and then cross 29 between Ellicott City and downtown Columbia and then make its way over toward the east. So one of the ways we watch this is by watching the wind speeds in the storm. And again, there is the potential for a tornado. Again, as Taylor was mentioning before, at times this has looked a lot weaker than the one that was in Carroll County earlier. At other times it looks pretty distinct. So it's too early to say whether they'll cancel this warning or not. There's definitely some rotation there with this storm as it's making its way through the Howard County area near Columbia. east-southeast at 20 miles an hour, so be careful. Be on the lookout. Catonsville and Elkridge, you guys could see this storm move in very quickly, and you don't want to, you know, let your guard down, even though it doesn't seem like much is going on in your area right now. Inside a home in the basement is the best place to be, and away from windows. And we do ask, you know, you send us reports of damage, but not until the storm has passed by and it's safe to take a look outside. Typically, bathrooms in the interior of room have turned out to be a safe place to be, or a hallway, and away from windows on that lowest level of your building. The National Weather Service monitor, it gives us updates when they can. Taylor, have you had any updates on chat at all?
Nothing right now. Still waiting for an update on the tornado warning.
Okay, so the warning in Howard County is continuing for the potential for a tornado there. It looks as if there may be something in that area down there just south of Columbia, south of downtown Columbia, maybe a possibility of some rotation. Not as dangerous as it looked just a few minutes ago, but definitely some rotation there. Perhaps the system is going to pass to the south of Columbia down in this location. Looks like if there is one there, it would be coming close to Route 29 now, south of Columbia, Route 29. Let me see if I can get in a little closer so we can get a better feel for where this could be. South of Elioke, bearing down on the Oakland Mills area in Columbia, and north of Simpsonville. So that's the general location of most concern, right in there, just southwest of Columbia and a few miles south of Ellicott City. So here's Ellicott City and this possible tornado be 4 or 5 miles south of that, but much closer to downtown Columbia, only a mile or two southwest of Columbia. And here's Route 29. It's within a mile or so in the latest sweep of the radar. So it's probably crossing or getting close to Route 29 right now, and will move over 29 and then over toward Elkridge in the next few minutes. This is going to get into you folks over there around Catonsville, Elkridge, this area, within 5 to 10 minutes or so. It's going to quickly sweep across that area and move in. So now is the time to plan for the possible storm moving in and take shelter before it even gets to your location. Strong rotation, again, indicated by our radar, and the National Weather Service maintaining that warning for about 2-3 more minutes. If they drop it, we will let you know. If not, we will continue to monitor the storm as it makes its way over toward the northern part, perhaps western Baltimore or northern Anne Arundel County in the next few minutes. Here's how it's tracked. You can kind of just track it right across Howard County there. You can see it staying south of Interstate 70, bearing down on Columbia. Now it looks like it's passing south of Columbia, probably crossing Route 29 even as we speak, or getting close to it, and moving east of Route 29. And getting set to head over into that eastern part of Howard County, south of Columbia, east of Route 29, moving over toward Wesley Grove, and maybe eventually over toward Interstate 95 in that location there. So I don't know if we have any other cameras down that way, Don, that might be able to show us pictures of what it's like there in Howard County, but it can't be very pleasant, that's for sure. Even if there's no tornado, there is some intense rainfall being indicated in the Columbia area right now. I mean, that rain is coming down, and that spot there north of Columbia are getting rain at the rate of 8.5 inches an hour. So that is a very heavy downpour. Thankfully, the storm won't be around that long to produce that much rain, but the intensity definitely shows you how strong that storm is. With the tops on this storm now getting even higher, storm is built up to 50,000 feet up into the atmosphere, so it is a very powerful storm. No doubt about it. And it does perhaps have some hail associated with it. Radar's been analyzing the part of the storm that could produce half-inch diameter hail as it's making its way through as well. So an intense thunderstorm with a tornado warning in effect until 5 o'clock, especially for areas in Howard County to the south of Columbia and moving over toward or across Route 29 and perhaps over toward Elkridge or Catonsville in the next few minutes. It's the general motion of the possible storm moving in this general location like that. So we'll see what the Weather Service does with it. And we're going to certainly have an update for you on weather conditions and the complete news wrap up at 5 o'clock in the next minute or so. So we'll be on the air regardless whether the Weather Service continues this warning or not. Severe thunderstorms have already been issued for Baltimore City, northern Anne Arundel County, and the southern part of Baltimore County. Because even though they've just extended that tornado warning, you can see that's it's going to go until 5:30.
Going to wait 9 to 12 months.
Next day delivery.
Actually posted, nothing quite yet.
Okay, so it looks like a tornado warning is going to continue for the cell as it makes its way out of Howard County over toward Glen Burnie and into northern Anne Arundel County. So hopefully we'll get some information from the Weather Service on their thinking with this, but it is definitely a dangerous storm system. Andre Hepkins is in the Weather Center. Andre, what have you got?
They just tweeted out tornado warning, including Columbia, Glen Burnie, Severn until 5:30.
Okay,
Eastern.
Yeah, so extending it off to the southeast area, into Anne Arundel County, including Severn and Glen Burnie. So storm system holding together. It is a very powerful storm system with a lot of energy with it and the potential for a tornado that the Weather Service doesn't want to let the guard down just yet. So here's where it has been extended. You can see now it goes from the Columbia area through Elkridge over toward Glen Burnie. It means another half hour of a possible tornado threat from this storm that's moving through. And so again, as we say a lot, you know, that when we're talking about these storms, we're trying to pinpoint the location of the rotation. But you want to prepare in advance. So since the storm is moving southeast at 20, 25 miles an hour, you know, it only takes a few minutes for it to get into your area. And so you want to plan ahead and take shelter before the worst of the weather gets there. These are some of the locations in the path of this possible tornado. From the Ellicott City, Columbia area to Elkridge, Lansdowne, Linthicum. It's going to take it over close to the BWI airport location, as a matter of fact, as it makes its way in that direction in the next half hour. So dangerous storm system that's going to cut across I-95 and perhaps do some damage as it's moving through. That's why the Weather Service issued this watch a few hours ago, wanted everybody to be alert that there could be severe storms. So the yellow shaded area is a tornado watch. All of this area could see possible, you know, thunderstorms that could produce tornadoes, and then south of us, a severe thunderstorm watch in effect. So our new tornado warning takes the storm out of Howard County into northern Anne Arundel County over the course of the next 30 minutes, and that is where we have tornado warnings in effect right now. I'm going to send it over to Taylor for an update on her information.
All right, so a lot of activity happening across the area. We actually just heard thunder, and the rain is certainly coming down overhead of us here at WBAL. Here's a live look at the line of storms, broken line of storms, I should say, moving into Baltimore right now. It extends all the way from northeast Maryland all the way down through D.C. into northern Virginia. Again, the pinpoint that we are watching here closely is that tornado warn storm, which is starting to show up more impressive on radar right now. Do you want to break down the storm system, exactly where it will be located over the next couple of minutes to hour? Elkridge around 519. We're talking Lansdowne around 526. Dundalk 548, and Edgemere at the top of the hour as well. Again, all this activity is moving extremely fast. So if you are in the line of any of these storms, really, you need to get into the lowest level of your house and certainly seek shelter away from windows. This is going to all move through extremely quickly, and you really don't have time to prepare. So get there right now. Here's a live look also at radar velocity. See where the reds and greens are coming together. It was showing up very impressive. Then it kind of fell apart here on radar. Now it's showing up more impressive just south and south and west of the city, closer towards Columbia. This is going to eventually track eastward over the bay and onto the eastern shore. We have that tornado watch that continues through 9 o'clock this evening, and also the severe thunderstorm watch that extends through 9 o'clock as well. I do think that the timeline of all this activity has moved up a little bit, so I do think it's also going to be out of here quicker. So you may even be able to get your evening plans in as well. Nonetheless, we do have the tornado warning that is still in effect for parts of the area. Again, tornado warning safety. Here's a live look at what to expect. Lowest level of your house, away from windows, in your basement, whatever it may be. This is going to move through very quickly. For now, I think we have an update. We're going to send it back over to Tom.
All right, Taylor, the tornado warning continues. Andre's phone just went off. It's an indication that it's nearby. The Weather Service can alert all cell phones with these worst storms, including tornado warnings, obviously. What did that information say there, Andre?
Anything reiterated what we are saying, and to take shelter now in the basement, in the interior room, you and Taylor have been telling everyone, or the lowest floor of a sturdy building. If you're outdoors in a mobile home or in a vehicle, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris. But reiterating the National Weather Service tornado warning in this area until 5:30 this evening.
Okay. Thank you very much, Andre. And here's the radar, again, analyzing this storm in Howard County and definitely showing us the strong rotation, as you can see with the storm tracks now, showing those tornadic symbols there. And so when we click on this, it gives us an estimate of towns that are in the path of the storm. I do think it's south of Ellicott City, but even in Ellicott City, you could get some damaging winds. Elkridge, Linthicum, Pumphrey, all moving off to the southeast at now 30 miles an hour. So the storm moving a little bit faster on its southeastern trek, but it's that dangerous thunderstorm there in Howard County that has got the Weather Service most concerned, and us as well, as we monitor the strong winds that are associated with it and the strong wind shear. It's wind shear, the change in wind speed and direction, that gives us an indication of where possible tornadoes are. When you think about it, a funnel or a spinning tornado has a very sharp change in wind speed and direction from the center of it and around the exterior of it. So when we see this on radar, we get very concerned. So right now, it looks like the strongest rotation would be bearing down on Interstate 95 in the eastern part of Howard County. I think I-95 north of Elkridge is that picture there. And traffic still moving along, although it looks a little slower. Very heavy rain certainly there. It looks like if we've got a tornado, this would be somewhere in the general vicinity of Waterloo, 175 on Interstate 95. I don't know if we have a camera in that area where 175, the I know there's an exit there for 175 on 95. Between, looks like it's between 100 and 175. Or somewhere in that general area, I think would be. It looks like it may even be crossing over that region now and heading over toward Anne Arundel County. Winds in this storm system are quite impressive. Again, we're getting some reports of some pretty strong winds and strong wind shear. So it's a dangerous storm, and that's why the warning goes until 5:30 this evening. Kim Dacey is in Columbia, and I think the worst of the storm will have passed her by, so let's see what she saw. Kim, what did you observe as the storm was moving through?
Well, Tom, I'm actually kind of on the east side of
95 right now. It appears to be the location of the strongest rotation indicated by radar, at least. And so that cell is a dangerous one. It's going to cross 95 and head on over into northern Anne Arundel County. And I would say that folks in Anne Arundel County near Shipley Corner, Glen Burnie, Woodcrest, Elkridge, and Howard County, you should all be taking shelter now, because funnels can drop down out of this thing, and it looks like there may well be a tornado associated with it in that area of Howard County. Now, Kim Dacey was saying she was a little bit east of Columbia, so she may be experiencing some pretty rough weather there, even as we speak, in that location there of Howard County. This is where the warning is in effect, and you can see it covers that entire region. I do think the worst of it is past 29 in Ellicott City in Columbia and is now getting over closer to Interstate 95. In the eastern part of Howard County, and will probably make it into northern Anne Arundel County the way it's looking right now, because this has got some lots of energy with it. Those whites and pinks you see at the center of this storm, that's intense rainfall coming down 14 inches per hour. So if the storm sat there for an hour, it would dump 14 inches. It's not going to be there for an hour, but that's the intensity of the storm, and it gives you a good feeling for how strong this storm is, with thunderstorm tops on it climbing up 45, 50,000 feet. And the potential to produce some significant hail as it moves on through as well. In this pink shaded, purple shaded area, the radar is estimating the hail could be over half an inch in diameter, maybe an inch in diameter in some spots. So serious thunderstorm, possibility that it has a tornado associated with it in that location in eastern Howard County, and moving over toward Interstate 95. So the radar updates every couple of minutes, and sometimes the storm will race out ahead of it. I think while the indication from our radar is that the funnel's over here, I think it's really probably pretty close to 95 now. Close to 95, somewhere in that Waterloo location. So between 175 and 100 would appear to be the location of this possible tornado crossing 95, heading southeast towards Severn, heading into Anne Arundel County, that could impact Severn, Stony Run, Glen Burnie in the next 20 minutes or so. I think I hear some heavy rain on our roof here. Is that heavy rain, Andre? Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's coming
definitely
down.
Definitely heavy rain.
It's coming down pretty good. I don't know, Andre, are you pretty good on social media. Have you seen any reports on social media of any damage reports?
I've been looking for damage. I haven't seen any reports of any damage yet.
Okay.
But
all right.
I'm hearing the people, including our own meteorologist, Ava Marie, who's hunkering down in the basement right now.
And that's where she should
advice.
Be.
She should be there.
Meteorologist knows where to go. Hopefully
absolutely.
She's got the boys with her. The storm is moving in this direction there, so it's going to get into northern Anne Arundel County. And it's a late afternoon, rush hour time. Probably not many folks are able to send us reports. But once the storm passes, if you have damage reports, we certainly want to hear about that to see what's going on. But if you're in the path of this storm, which is coming across Interstate 95, heading into northern Anne Arundel County now, out of Howard County, you want to take it seriously. It's a dangerous storm system in the general vicinity of Waterloo, moving over towards Severn, eventually getting over toward Glen Burnie and Southgate, but probably close to, if not crossing 95 as we speak, in Route 1 as it makes its way through the extreme eastern part of Howard County at this time. Taylor, have we got any updates from the National Weather Service?
Still continuing. Oh, it looks like they just canceled. Oh, no, sorry. Okay. They continued part of the tornado warning, but canceled it for other areas. So
okay. yeah.
That literally just came in. But we are getting some pictures in on the National Weather Service chat of the of funnel clouds. They look pretty impressive as the storm actually moved through Howard County. So
okay.
Again, all the reports are getting a little bit delayed because people are actually in the storm. But if you do, or if you can take any kind of pictures safely and send them to us, please do so. And we will continue to get those out for you.
Okay, appreciate it. Yeah, it's definitely a dangerous storm. And so if we've had confirmation with funnel clouds, very good possibility. You know, funnel clouds is just a tornado that hasn't touched down. Once it touched down, then it is a tornado. People may be seeing the funnel and not knowing if it's touched down or not. So just the fact that we're getting pictures of that kind of confirms the dangerous aspect of this storm system, which is sitting there near Interstate 95 and Route 1 in the eastern part of Howard County, between the just north of Savage, and moving quickly over in toward the northern parts of Anne Arundel County. This is the area of concern that we've got. And we don't want anybody to really kind of take it lightly. It's a dangerous storm that's been spotted. Funnel clouds have been spotted. Pictures have been taken. And so it's not just indicated by radar. It's definitely a storm that has a serious threat to that area from eastern Howard County into northern Anne Arundel County. And so you do want to get low. Basements are safest places in a house, the lowest level of a building that has multiple stories to it, away from windows, interior rooms is where you want to go. Let me put our tornado safety tips up there again for you, just to kind of reiterate it. It's kind of common sense, but it's tempting to go out near a window and kind of take a look and see what's going on, but unfortunately, flying debris in windows are dangerous scenarios. So I'm looking at the National Weather Service as they update their chat. And they are still saying that this is going to continue for now, located over the south of the Elkridge area, moving east at 25 miles an hour. And so that's where we've kind of got this storm system and a dangerous situation from eastern Howard County into northern Anne Arundel. The bigger picture here of the storm, let me see if we can get a close picture of that intense rainfall and the numerous lightning strikes that go along with it, and the potential for some hail and damaging winds as it moves through. A little farther north, heavy rain in Towson. A little farther south, a severe thunderstorm near Wheaton in Montgomery County. These are all moving southeast. I think in the next hour or so, they're going to be pressing very rapidly past Baltimore and down to, over into southern Maryland, the eastern shore. So this is the leading edge of some cooler air that's going to bring some heat relief, but that front has really kicked up some nasty thunderstorms, including this one here where we have a tornado warning in effect until 5:30. That does include areas in eastern Howard County. It does get into Severn, Shipley Corner, Glen Burnie, south of Elkridge, down to Southgate. That entire area is prone to possibility of some damaging winds with a possible tornado making its way through the region. So let's again monitor the rotation here. Not as distinct on that one from Sterling, a little better there from Dover. BWI, this storm is actually getting pretty close to them. They may be almost too close to get a good feel for this, although we do see some high winds there, indicated by the 92 mile an hour winds, indicated by the BWI radar site. So they're definitely picking up on some dangerous stuff there near Waterloo. And again, I think that is the area where it's moving. It's moving out of Waterloo in the general direction of Severn, Probably tracking between Route 100 and Route 175. I think that would be the area of most concern from the Waterloo area there along or just east of 95 heading over into northern Andrew. Okay, you know, the storm will have been passed through that area, but let's take a look at some pictures from the Howard County Fairgrounds area. And is this current now? Yeah, it looks like cars are going by there yeah, now.
A few minutes ago.
A few minutes ago? Oh, a little old. Okay, yeah. So interesting shot there for sure. The storm moved through that West Friendship area and is now over in the eastern part of Howard County, but that's definitely an interesting picture. So let's go back to radar and give you a feeling for where this location is. The Waterloo area of eastern Howard County, moving southeast at 25 miles an hour. It's only about 5 miles from Severn, so that's a fifth of an hour, if you will, or whatever, just 12 minutes or so, it would be in that location. So take shelter now in Anne Arundel County. Storm system with a possible tornado is coming out of Howard County and moving in your direction. And the Weather Service has extended that warning that the red shaded area all the way over there east of Interstate 97. So that gives you a feeling for where the storm could track if it held together along that entire pathway of the storm system. Very heavy rain, dangerous lightning, damaging winds, possible tornado as it makes its way through the region. So here's the bigger picture of it. And again, the radar is trying to catch up to the storm as it makes its way through. That symbol, I think, is a little west of where the actual strongest rotation would be at this time. But that's the general motion of the storm. And so if you are in these areas from Elkridge to Linthicum to Pumphrey, you do want to be taking shelter now, you know, getting in the safest location you can possibly be before the storm reaches you. This is the motion over the course of the past hour, and you'll see that storm making its way across almost all of Howard County from the western part or along Interstate 70 through the Columbia area and now crossing 95 and heading south into northern Anne Arundel County. So it's been a long track and it's had the possibility of producing some damage all along that track. And it is going to continue to be a problem, I think, as it gets into northern Anne Arundel County. So you can monitor the intensity by seeing how tall the storm is. At one point, it was up to 50,000 feet. Now it's up around 45,000 feet. And it is still producing some pockets of hail and intense amounts of rain as it makes its way through the region. So be careful in this location. We've got a tornado possible coming out of the Waterloo area of Howard County and moving between routes 100 and 175. Moving southeast toward the Severn area in northern Anne Arundel County. I'm going to check in with Taylor to see if she's gotten any updates from our friends at the National Weather Service.
All right, still no updates right now. They should be coming out with something soon, just issuing tornado warnings. But I do want to take you to a wider view of what's happening right now, because we do have some storms that are starting to get more intense, mainly around D.C. for now. As you can see, we do have the radar indicated map part of rotation showing up here, mainly south and west of D.C. You can see up towards Montgomery County as well. And again, we still have that tornado warn storm around Howard County. And there we go. Better look of exactly what towns to expect over the next couple of minutes to an hour. Glen Burnie around 5:35. Could see near Lakeshore around 6 o'clock, and it's going to continue to move very, very quickly to the east, south, and east. So again, something we've been talking about all afternoon long is that this storm system is moving extremely fast. So we're going to see these tornado warnings possibly pop up, and as they do, it's going to be so fast you really won't have time to prepare. Nonetheless, outside of the tornado warnings, this is certainly a very big severe threat. All these storms are very intense, blinding rainfall, very strong winds, lightning, and even the potential for hail as well. This is something we have been watching closely, which we typically do during tornado warnings or a tornado threat, the radar velocity. When the reds and greens come together, that goes to show you that there is the potential of storm rotation within storm systems. Again, we do have the tornado watch through 9 o'clock, severe thunderstorm watch, which extends south and west of the city through 9 o'clock as well. Again, an update on tornado safety, which we will continue to bring you throughout the day. Inside a sturdy home, lowest level of your house, possibly the basement, and away from windows as well. We'll send it back over to Tom with another update.
All righty, Taylor. And again, National Weather Service has dropped the warning in Howard County. As you can see, The new red shaded area does not include the Howard County area, so it's now primarily a threat in northern Anne Arundel County. That's where the warning continues. And again, as we mentioned, it looked like it had been crossing over out of the I-95 Route 1 corridor there in eastern Howard County and making its way over into the northern sections of Anne Arundel County. And that indeed is what we see right now. And so the warning goes until 5:30, primarily for that location there in the northern sections of Anne Arundel County. And again, I think the storm is coming out of that area there, south of 100, north of 175, moving generally to the east and impacting areas most likely to be impacted would be areas north of 175 and over towards Severn and along the Route 100 corridor over toward Glen Burnie. It looks like those locations would probably be most threatened by a possible tornado coming in this general direction out of the Waterloo area of eastern Howard County. But again, for Howard County, the threat of a tornado is rapidly diminishing, and the Weather Service has dropped that warning for Howard County. It's just a severe thunderstorm there now. The tornado warning is from generally the BWI area, south along 97 into Glen Burnie, down towards Severn, and that location of Anne Arundel County. So please, be safe in that location. Get to the lowest level of your building. Stay away from windows and wait for the sound of the storm to pass you by. Most of Maryland is dealing with the potential for severe weather. Yellow shaded area on this map is where tornadoes could pop up. Pink shaded is where very strong thunderstorms could pop up. And of course, there in northern Anne Arundel County is where we may have a tornado, the possibility of that moving through the region. Looks like this could come very close to BWI as it makes its way across the region, although the most, maybe just south of that, maybe just south of BWI would be the prime location. This is the radar beam coming out of BWI, and I'm not sure that that is updated or not, so I don't know if we're getting a fresh update on that one. This is the Sterling, Virginia one. The Sterling, Virginia one in eastern Howard County, and then the Dover, Delaware one, which is a little farther away, shooting a little higher up into the storm. The meteorologist Ava Marie hunkered down and getting ready for the storm to pass by. Ava, what have you seen so far in your area?
I'll tell you, we're just starting to hear the thunder. So it goes to show just how calm it can be, even when you are in a tornado warning. Until the very leading edge of that storm gets in, you may not realize that something significant is heading your way. I was actually grateful that we got well advanced warning, because the emergency alert system that's now on most cell phones actually went off when this warning was only in Howard County. It's all based on cell towers. So even though I was far away from the actual warning, I was close enough to a cell tower in Howard County in order to trigger that alert. I was grateful for that because I've got kids, I'm trying to cook dinner, and so I knew to keep an eye out as the storm moved our way. Well, now we're in the warning, so we're in the basement. And you don't always talk about where to go in your safe place, but as parents, think about some things you can bring down to your safe place just to keep the kids occupied and not so worried as well. The kids usually aren't allowed in our storage room. Well, I open it up. That's where all the extra toys are, the ones that are, we're trying to get rid of. They're playing with those right now, so it's definitely keeping them occupied. So think about that. Go to your safe place and be comfortable there for a while, because you may be waiting this out for about 20 minutes.
So I got to ask, what are you making for dinner?
Oh, I'm hungry. Tuna noodle casserole. I was going for easy because it's a busy night. But, hey, I had to stop that. I turned off the water. We went right to the basement.
There you go.
But, yeah, it's amazing that the rotation could be so close to us. And we're just starting to get the rain. And it's hardly that windy yet. But I know the leading edge is not far from us.
Yeah, and you said you started to hear some thunder there. There are lots of lightning strikes coming out of this storm. That's going to be a dangerous part of it as it bears down on you. I mean, we're seeing numerous lightning strikes associated with a very active storm system that's coming into northern Anne Arundel County now.
Yeah, and just as you're talking, I'm just starting to see the winds pick up as well. But again, you don't want to wait for those indicators. Even my neighbor called and asked, hey, I see we're in a warning. What should I listen for? And yes, you always hear those classic stories of what does it sound like in a tornado warning. But when you're hearing those noises, you're really in the thick of the storm. You want to be heading to your safe place well before you're even hearing the sounds or signs of what would be a typical tornado situation. And that's why we have these warnings that come out. And thankfully, the cell phones now, because they do give people advance warning no matter where they are.
Yeah, we don't want it to be where you feel like, hey, they issued a warning and nothing happened. We're issuing the warnings early so that you can take plenty of time to get in a safe spot. No doubt about it. Exactly right, Ava. And that's why this storm warning, the tornado warning, extends even past 97, Interstate 97, past Glen Burnie into the central part there of northern Anne Arundel County. So, again, it may be quiet, as Ava was mentioning. It seems like the calm is literally the calm before the storm, but it comes on you very quickly, and so that's why the warnings go out well in advance, at least hopefully several minutes of an advance of a possible thunderstorm that has a tornado bearing down on your area. Right now, we're trying to keep a close eye on where this system is, and it's not as distinct, but it does look like it's in the far northwestern part of Anne Arundel County, moving southeast at about 25 miles an hour. So it is still just getting into Anne Arundel County as best we can tell. BWI's radar site does not look to me like it has sent us an update in a while. That looks like an old image to me, although it is possible that it's still sitting out there over that part of Interstate 95. I think the worst of the storm and the most strongest rotation is just now getting into or very close to the Howard Anne Arundel County line. And we'll see, based on the rainfall, it's definitely making its way in that direction very quickly. So it should be coming into northern Anne Arundel County, north of Severn, over toward Glen Burnie in the next several minutes or so. Our warning goes until 5:30, and we'll see if the Weather Service maintains that, extends it, what they decide to do as far as analyzing this storm. But that's where the warning is right now, in that red shaded area, which does include areas from Shipley Corner to Glen Burnie, south of Elkridge, and all the way down Interstate 97. And so you can see those locations and towns that are in the threat area for a possible tornado. It does include Linthicum, does include the BWI Marshall Airport location. It does include Severn and Glen Burnie and Southgate as well. And so everybody here in this location will be dealing with some very intense rain and possibly some damaging winds as the storm makes its way through. The heaviest rain is still coming out of Howard County and moving toward northern Anne Arundel. And Andre Hepkins joins me in the Weather Center with another update.
Somebody from Severn tweeting us saying, Severn checking in, no damage yet.
Okay, no damage yet in Severn. All right, it looks like they may be still a few minutes away from getting the worst of this storm as it moves in from the northwest and tracks southeast into that area of Anne Arundel County. So there's the strongest storm system right there. And again, making its way southeast at about 20 to 25 miles an hour. So that's the location there. And I have a feeling that we may need to refresh this as far as getting updated information, because that looks like our radar information is being delayed a little bit. I have a feeling that storm is a little farther east. And on the last couple of images here, we're not advancing quite as much. So I'll keep an eye on that, make sure we're getting fresh data in. But I'm a little suspicious that that radar doesn't look like it has updated in the past couple of minutes for us. So let me make sure we're doing that. But this is where the warning goes until 5:30 this evening. And again, it includes that large chunk in northwestern sections of Anne Arundel County. Yeah, Taylor?
They expired the warning.
They just expired the warning for Anne Arundel?
Yes.
Okay, well, that's good news to hear for sure. And keep your guard up, folks. We're still under the watch. A tornado watch remains in effect for possible other storms that could produce tornadoes as they move through. But at least for now, the main threat seems to has ended. And so I think I'm going to toss it over to the news, folks. Andre, do you or toss it back to main programming?
Sure.
Let me hear somebody talk to me.
And while we're waiting for an update, our friend in Severn checked in with us again. Severn checking in again, right in the path indicated by Tom, Maryland Route 170 and 174. No rain yet, but thunder is growing.
Okay, very good. Thank you very much.